All right, so on the 15th of April, 2024, Mr. Kwekudaku Jima of Jima Photography and Jima Weddings posted on his Instagram, personal Instagram, that there's going to be a workshop, practically going to educate photographers on the business side of photography. This event was scheduled to be exactly 1 week after the post, and it was open for everyone to register. Unfortunately, they had a maximum capacity of 40 participants. And funny enough, when the lines were open for people to register, it just took 16 minutes for it to be filled out. Now, this should tell you how patiently people were waiting for this. I myself, I had to set an alarm for the exact moment because I knew it was going to drop at 12 p.m. So between 12 p.m. and 4 p.m., that is where the link was going to be dropped. The moment it dropped at 12 p.m., I had registered. So in this video, I'm practically going to talk about my experience going for the workshop, what I learned, and basically the tips and tricks about everything with regards to how the workshop was organized and all of that is going to be in this video. Unfortunately, I can't share everything though, because it was quite a lengthy program from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. I can't talk about everything in a single video, but here's how it went. So just like everyone else, I didn't know how they got there, but I requested a driver from the boat app and I got there using the boat app.
Your destination is on the left.
I'm not going for some boy. Maybe I'll. Hey, now then we'll be a share, sir.
Now the program was supposed to start at 10 a.m. and when I got there at 10:14 thereabout, it was already flooded with a lot of people. I went ahead to greet a couple of people who looked familiar and I've already met before, and also went ahead to sign to show that I was present. So I'm here. We are here at the Baba Academy, Cloudy. Is it Cloudy X? They say it's Cloudy X Mr. Brothers, but over here, as you can clearly see, it is a star. Anyway, at the moment, we are just hanging around because they have to get some ventilation thing going on in there, making sure that everyone is comfortable. So we've not entered at the moment. But whatever be the case, I'm done with the registration. You just write your name and your email address. When you are done, you guys will see how it looks like on the inside. Some pretty nice buildings are here too as well. Yeah, since we haven't started, let me get some water to drink as well. Hey, I'm thirsty. I should have brought one from home. Okay, there's one here. And I'm on, you know. I should want to see all. Yeah, you see. Ultimately, the first thing to do right now would be to socialize with a lot of people. But you know me, I have problems socializing with people, especially when I am not doing my work. If I have a camera with me, then definitely I can walk up to people and start talking. But the camera is in my bag, so I don't know. Let's see, if I get to talk to people, I'll let you guys know. Or let you guys in on it as well. Madam Planner, you're always busy.
Yeah, chill.
Hope you're good.
Yes, I'm good.
I'm good myself. And share. Hopefully you'll be entering soon.
Yes, definitely.
How do you? Oh yeah, that's Mr. Kwekudaku Jima with just a little bit of handshake.
Entering.
I'm going to go to the
Oh,
no.
Obviously, I got the chance to speak to people I haven't met before and other creatives that I have been seeing their posts on social media and all of those other platforms, but I haven't really interacted with them before. One of such members was Elom from Fission Media. I've been watching a lot of TikTok videos from his page, liking and commenting on a lot of them, but this was my first time meeting him in person.
I don't know what name you're familiar, sir.
Fission. Great content,
yeah. TikTok. Yeah.
I think I've seen
your videos. Yeah, me too, I've seen your videos. Welcome.
Good morning. My name is Kojo Kwati. I'm a lifestyle and portrait photographer. I also shoot weddings under the brand name To Love and To Hold. I'm here today because Gemma is one of the photographers that we look up to, and when seeing the flyer, I saw that to be a great opportunity to learn some insights into wedding photography.
Okay, good morning. My name is Alfred. I'm from Castor.
Wow.
I got lost, but I begin as well. I started like 5 months now. And I'm so intrigued. Imagine I'm introducing to all of us. You can feel that, right?
Yeah.
We get to learn more, there's pros and cons together.
So we got to the part that everyone had to introduce themselves, and this is what I said.
Hello everyone, my name is Theo Labi. I'm a content creator primarily. I also take pictures on Theo Studios, but for the past 5 years I've been shooting videos for PDY Weddings. So I just came out starting my own photography business, and I want to know the business side of photography as well. I'm also a YouTuber, so anyway.
Now, at some point, everyone was talking about their experiences. We were going back and forth with questions and answers. Then I shared my experience with losing a client file. Basically, we didn't lose the entire file. I lost my files, the B-rolls, because I shoot with a gimbal. I lost those files, and we couldn't recover them, and how I dealt with the whole situation. I had to share it with them and give my recommendations as to how they can avoid such a situation from happening to them as well.
So I was backing up the files onto my external hard drive. It got to 75%, then it just stopped working. So basically, we got some of the video files for the client, the main ones, but I'm with the gimbal, I'm walking past through there because I know I'm going to overlap it with mine. So exactly, no B-roll. And since then, now every single time we go for weddings, I back up 3 times. So I have a 6 terabyte hard disk at home, which is basically storing all the backups. I carry 2 hard drives with me. So the first backup will go onto that. The second one will go onto the second one, which I will give to a photographer. He will go to a different location altogether. So anything can happen to us. And I always try not to format the SD card after a program. So the next one, I have to get a different SD card until I'm done with the trailer. Share. Anyway.
Can create for the client. You're comparing yourself to what Gemma would presumably produce. Now, who is to say that they are not coming to you because of what you create and not just the budget? And there's this assumption again that if a brand has existed before you, you cannot outprice it. That's also another mistake, because it stems from the mindset that you are going to do the same thing they are doing. But if you are doing something they are not doing, and a client finds value in that, why are you not pricing more or equal as the people who have been doing it for 5-10 years? Because if that were the case, there would be no need to start new companies. Everything you are doing today has existed 10 years ago, 20 years ago. So why are you doing this? You understand? So you should have confidence in your unique selling point, what exactly it is that you are bringing to the table.
So we'll take a break, and then once we come back, we'll have the panel sit down, and then we'll just, this one has to be 30 minutes, you just ask your questions, we answer, and then we call it a day. Thank you guys so much.
So after the first session, we went on a quick break.
Break time.
There was food, which was quite interesting, because for a program that was free, getting all of this knowledge for free, we were provided with water, food, and drinks. Jima and his team did an amazing job with that, because not anyone in Ghana is practically doing what he is doing at the moment. So for this initiative, myself and everyone else who came for the program, we were all very grateful for that.
Okay, we just went out for break. I'm super tired, sort of sleepy, but you're better than it. So, I suppose we should get something to eat first. Then later we come back to the workshop again for some panel discussion. And it is during that time that we can ask our questions and get some answers based on what we ask. So for the time being, this is what we are doing. Sorry I'm not looking at you, I'm a bit distracted.
Also present were a couple of people I have been following their work but haven't met before. One being Weddings by Steve Morris, Gog Photography, Kwekwanasi Photography was also present, and a whole lot of other people. Kojo Inshiraba Photography was also there. I know him personally because we've already met in Takrade. Yeah, so basically the whole experience was quite great. If it was a paid course, definitely I'm going to register for it one more time. I went ahead with my book, I jotted down a bunch of things, and I realized there are a lot of things I'm doing very, very wrongly. So from now onwards, I'm going to take my photography business a lot more seriously. If clients are not talking to me or are trying to devalue the kind of content I give them in terms of photography and video, you just have to let them go. The bottom line is just let them go. Learn to say no, even if you need the money, because what we are doing, preserving memory, is not something that anyone else can do. You will notice that when you go for weddings or anything of that sort, or people who have even gotten married and all of that, any other vendor, correct me if I'm wrong, but any other vendor, the caterers, the deco, the DJ, those handling the lights and all of that, practically everyone else goes home with their equipment and they just go to bed and focus on the next project. But with photography or videography or this media space, for example, we still have to go back, edit the photos, edit the videos, still be in connection with the clients, making sure that they are still satisfied with everything. And the bottom line is they're not even going to remember how the deco looked like, how the cake looked like, how it tasted like, how good the music was, or how bad the lighting was and all of that, if they are not preserved in images and videos for them to watch over and over and over again. So in actual sense, the work we do is timeless for everyone to appreciate. You'll notice that there are videos popping up, people going to cemeteries, scanning a QR code, and they notice that there are videos from probably a couple who had passed away. I mean, where are you going to get those kind of content if they didn't record themselves? So pictures and videos are quite important. They preserve memories as much as possible. So we in this creative space, doing this kind of job, this is what we have to make sure that everyone understands. They have to put value on the kind of work that we are doing. That is what I'm going to leave you guys with. So let me know, guys, if you like this style of content. Let me know by hitting the thumbs up. If you like to watch more of our videos, hit that subscribe button. And as always, don't forget to share with your family and friends. This is Theo from Fino Concept. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one.